Climate change affects everyone, but did you know children, especially those living in marginalized communities, are particularly vulnerable? Let's take a trip to three communities in Malaysia to see how climate change affects children's futures. Our first stop, Pulau Gaya, an island off the coast of Sabah. Meet Dido. He is a Bajau boy. His father is a fisherman. His mother makes salted fish to sell at the market. They live in a village built on stilts above the seawater. To get to school, Dido and his friends take a boat. They are always happy to be at school. Today, it is raining heavily. The weather fluctuates frequently due to climate change. When the rain gets too heavy, Dido and his friends cannot go to school. His dad cannot go out to catch fish. Thankfully, they can depend on salted fish to eat. Dido's mom sells crafts made from shells and pearls to supplement their income. For the community in Pulau Gaya, climate change means more rain. While rain provides fresh water, too much rain means children can't go to school and parents don't get to work. With less money, many families cannot afford to buy fresh food. Next, let's visit Pos Kuala Lumu in Perak. The village sits in the interior of the Pia Forest Reserve. The forest protects the whole village from extreme heat. Juria is a Temia girl. Like most of her neighbours, her parents have a farm. They catch fish in the rivers. They are blessed with available food all year round. Every day, Juria walks to school. Recently, there are days when the rains don't stop. The rains can make the river water rise and swell. The villagers can't cross the river. The heavy rain also causes landslides. This makes it dangerous for Juria and her friends to go to school. For indigenous communities, such as the Temia in Perak, heavy rain can cause flash floods and landslides. This puts the villagers, especially the children, at risk. Here's our last stop, Kuala Lumpur. Unlike Juria, Bala feels the extreme heat during the dry season. His parents tell him that it is much hotter these days than before. They live in a city and are surrounded by tall buildings. This traps heat and makes it hotter than the other areas. Together with the higher temperatures caused by climate change, it can get unbearable. Bala's family feels the pinch when extreme weather impacts agricultural farms, as this causes the prices of vegetables and other fresh food supplies to rise. This becomes a burden on Bala's family, who does not have a high income level. Rising prices means less food on the table. Children who live in urban areas enjoy better access to clean water, electricity, education, and health facilities. But they still suffer indirectly from the effects of climate change in other places. Stories like this exist everywhere around the country. Dido, Juria, and Bala are children who enjoy their lives and are happy to take each day as it comes. But wouldn't it be wonderful if they could live a life that is secure in a safe, healthy, and sustainable environment and plan their futures so that they can reach their full potential?